I offered to make a video, and a user requested it in the comments. So here is how to use the Scripting Listener plugin for Adobe Photoshop. This plugin generates code to use in scripts for tasks that regular code can't do. For example, adding a mask to a layer. Use Scripting Listener to record doing it and copy the code the plugin generates. First, you need the Scripting Listener plugin. In the description are links to the web page about the plugin and links to specific downloads. Using the plugin is the same on macOS and Windows, but installing it is different. I'll explain how to install both, starting with Windows. Once downloaded, extract the zip file. Inside are folders for 32 and 64-bit versions. Most likely you're using a recent version of Photoshop, which should be 64-bit. I'll assume that's the case. Go into the Win64 folder. Then the folder Scripting Utilities. There is the plugin. ScriptListener.8li. Right-click and copy the file. This needs to go in the Photoshop folder. Go to the C drive. Program Files. Adobe. Find the Photoshop folder and open it. Open the Plugins folder. Right-click and paste to copy the file into this folder. Because it's under Program Files, you have to authenticate. Click Continue. Close File Explorer. And the Scripting Listener plugin is installed. macOS is similar. First, move the downloaded zip file to your desktop. Double-click to extract the zip. And there is the plugin file, scriptinglistener.plugin. Open the Go menu. Select Applications. Find the Photoshop folder and open it. Open the Plugins folder. Drag the Scripting Listener plugin to the Plugins folder. Because it's under Applications, you have to authenticate. Close the Plugins folder. And the Scripting Listener plugin is installed. The remaining steps are the same for macOS and Windows. I'll go back to Windows for the rest. If Photoshop is open, quit and relaunch it. Once Photoshop is open again, you should see two files on your desktop. Both are named Scripting Listener Log. One JS, another VB. JS for JavaScript and VB for Visual Basic. We'll use the JavaScript log. You can open the file in any text editor, but I suggest using an editor that auto-updates as the file changes. Notepad is a poor choice because it doesn't update, so you'll have to close and open the file over and over again. I'll assume you're using VS Code to write scripts, as I suggested in part 1 of this tutorial series. That's a better choice for many reasons, but also because it auto-updates as the log file changes, which it does a lot. In VS Code, go to the File menu. Select Open File, and navigate to your desktop. Open the file scriptinglistener.js.log. You'll see the log is full of entries. This is a recording of Photoshop launching. None of it is needed, so select all and delete it. Save the file so that excess is gone for good. And remember, every time clearing the log, immediately save it. More about that in a moment. Switch to Photoshop and open an image. Now go back to VS Code. Look at all the new entries. The Scripting Listener has logged everything that happens when opening an image. We don't need Scripting Listener to know how to open images. There's the app open method for that. The goal is to focus on steps we can't do with regular code. So first, in Photoshop, have the image ready to perform the steps you want to record. Then in VS Code, clear the log and save it to reduce how much to sift through. That's the trick to using Scripting Listener. Keep the log clear so you're not overwhelmed by the countless lines of code the plugin generates. Then in Photoshop, do the steps you want to record and nothing more. I'll use a path to mask the image. Select the path, turn it into a selection, then mask the layer. Like when recording an action, now that we're done, don't click anything else. It only adds more to the log. Go to VS Code and let's see what we have. What the scripting listener does is record events, things that happen in Photoshop, and convert them to JavaScript code. Individual events are separated by a commented line of equal signs. Many times, it's not difficult to decipher what is what. Here we see host focus changed. That's the app focus changing from and to Photoshop as we switch back to VS Code. We don't need any of those. Or the history state changed. Clear out all of those two events. Now, before anything else happens, copy what remains. I'll make a new document and name it Adobe Script Tutorial 10.jsx. And paste in the code. Three steps were recorded. Select the path, make a selection of the path, and make a mask. Back at Photoshop, let's step the history back to the open document and make an action to run the tutorial script. In the Actions panel flyout menu, select New Action. Name it Tutorial 10. Go to the File menu, Scripts, Browse. Navigate to the tutorial script and select it. The script should run and give the same result as before. Click the Actions panel Stop button. For more about how to set up scripts in Photoshop, see the link in the description for another video that shows the steps. Back in VS Code, I want to point out that we didn't actually need to record all of these events. The only event that can't be done with regular code is making the mask. I'll comment out the first two events and accomplish the same with only three lines of code. Var doc equals app active document. Var path 1 equals doc path items get by name path 1. Path 1 make selection. Save the script, then go back to Photoshop. Back up the history again. Run the script, and you can see it gives the same result. There's no harm in recording more events than you need. It's just the code isn't as clear. So if it can be done with regular code, that's always better. I know to use path 1, so it's a simple matter to make a selection from the path using regular code, as I've shown. Here you can see in the recorded event, path 1. That event is selecting the path by its name. The event that turns it into a selection isn't as clear. Sometimes it's easy to figure out, sometimes not. That's why it helps to keep the log clear so it only lists what you're looking for. Now I'll show a real example of using code from Scripting Listener. This is an actual script that you can download from my website. Process folder. To download it, see the link in the description. I made this script to use with Scripting Listener. It's similar to some of the tutorial code for Photoshop we've already covered. The purpose is to choose a folder and open each image in it. Then call a function, process file, that has code copied from Scripting Listener. I've marked where to start and where to end, pasting the code from the log. This example, I recorded adding a levels adjustment layer and setting the values. I'll run this script and choose a folder I've set up with three images. Once the script is done, look at one of the results. a levels adjustment layer has been added. The values I've used are extreme to better show the effect, and to show that setting specific values is possible. For a real job, I wouldn't make adjustments so intense. You can download and use this script with your own values and add a levels adjustment layer to countless images. That's just one example. The events recorded by Scripting Listener can be anything done in Photoshop. One last thing about the plugin. Notice the log file has grown. A lot. And keeps growing the more we do anything in Photoshop. So it's not a plugin you want to leave installed all the time. Go back to the Photoshop folder, Plugins folder, and remove the Listener plugin. What I've done is make another folder named Plugins Disabled. Drag the plugin there. That way, when you want to use it again, just drag it back. Of course, you have to authenticate because we're touching the Program Files folder. Then close and restart Photoshop. After that, the two log files on the desktop can be trashed. Like this video if you found it helpful, and subscribe so you're notified of future videos. Any questions or ideas for new scripts, leave a comment. Your comments are a great source of inspiration. All feedback is welcome. There are many more scripts and videos for them. Click the video or playlist on screen for more. Thank you for watching.